Before the accident, I was thinking that I'll be a lawyer when I grow up. And then since then, I started selling pure water, be sending my grandmother small change, be keeping my own. Sometimes I sleep in the shop, sometimes I sleep in the street, sometimes I sleep in that will show the market side. Even to now, sir. I came to Lagos selling pure water. Some driver will pity me and stop. Some passenger will buy. Sometimes the passenger will take my money away. But I know it's to run, follow motor. If I see that the motor is moving, I will not sell. If I see that the motor is stopped, I will sell to the passenger. There is a car that wants to jam here, in this road here. Not that I don't even know. I just forgot myself. Don't know what I'm thinking now. I'm just crossing. But there is one policeman that is here. There is the policeman that pushed me one side. I say, I want to die. I say, no, I don't want to die. I have this accident that is 2006. I am 10 years old by that time. When we are going to village with me and my mom and dad, when we have this accident. Because we are in 16 passenger in that car. I'm the only surviving person. People around them take me to hospital and take my mom's phone, try some numbers, reach my mom, my grandmother that is in the village in Kogi State. Before she come down to Benue State, Makurdi. Before she came, self, they already cut the leg already. Before she came, they said the leg is too bad. Because if I stay like 2 days, I will die. Before they cut the leg. After then, my grandma take me to the village Kogi to stay. As I stay with her some time, looking at no help, nothing. I just traveled to Onitsha. That is 2016. I am 20 years that time. When I started selling pure water, be sending my grandmother small change, be keeping my own. Before that, my grandmother just called me that there is a guy that is interested in me that I should come. When I went to Kogi, she said that this is the guy. But the guy said, you take care of me, I will not lack anything. After that, the guy take me home to his place in Ayingba. When I'm pregnant, the boy did not even care for me. It's me that is feeding myself with the pregnancy. The hospital, I'm the one. Everything, I'm the one. From there, there's one of my friends in Asaba, closer to Onitsha, called me that I should come. That there is business there, like this pure water. There's old up used to move. I said, okay. And then I just came to Asaba. That 2016 now. I came with the pregnancy. Start selling the pure water. I called the guy that I should come to Asaba so that I would stay together. Because I have rent house on my own. The guy came, started staying together till I get back to my baby. That is last year, 2020 January. There is a man that saw me in hold up. And there is one trailer that's coming to come and hit me. The man just saw me in hold up that, why am I selling pure water? Told the man my condition, I explained everything to him. The man said, okay, he will interview me and send it to his junior brother. That is outside. After that, the man do the interview that day. That is February. He did the interview. I got home that evening. The guy called me, asked me some question, and then I asked him. He said that if 500,000 can reach me to start a business, I said yes. He sent me the 500,000 because I did not tell my baby father because I did not trust him. As they left, started asking me, so I have that kind of amount. I did not tell him. I said, no, it's not like that. I just will let the money complete before I tell you so that we will know what to do with the money. Started shouting, talking. I did not answer him. We just slept that night. Before daybreak, take my phone and my ATM and run away. So I went to bank access to withdraw the money. How much I remember is only 2,000 naira. living in that account. And then since then, I did not see him again. After then, take my baby to my grandmother. I said, anyhow, I will stay in Lagos. I'll be sending them small, small money. I said, if I have the opportunity, I will go and learn tailor to use and train my baby. Because when I'm young, I used to help my neighbor sew some things, some small, small things. That is then, not now. Because now, there's no chance for me. But if I see the opportunity to stop this piota, I will go and learn the tailor to use and train my baby tomorrow. Because I can use one leg to sew.